My name's Kathy Farley, and for those of you who know me, you know I love to have fun and joke around, but I today have such an urgency and a sense of the seriousness in my spirit. I remember this saying that some people like to have fun in life and get in serious trouble, while other people get serious about life and have fun. And that's the way I feel today. God is really calling an awakening to his sons and daughters to get involved with prayer and to seek him with his whole heart. And we have a call Las Vegas that's coming up. And it's my desire just to exhort, encourage you to get involved. Just today I read something where Paul Harvey had a radio broadcast. And we know there's always been the fight between light and dark. And Lucifer was the angel of light. And he came to run and rule this earth. But God today is calling his sons and daughters forth. And we've kind of given him room. And there was a saying back ago that all it takes for evil to prevail is for good people to do nothing. And anyways, this radio broadcast that I just read this morning by Paul Harvey just so stirred my spirit, and I just want to read it to you. And it's entitled, If I Were the Devil. And it goes like this. If I were the devil, I would gain control of the most powerful nation in the world. I would delude their minds into thinking that they had come from man's efforts instead of God's blessing. I would promote an attitude of loving things and using people instead of the other way around. I would dupe entire states into relying on gambling for their state revenue. I would convince people that character is not an issue when it comes to leadership. I would make it legal to take the life of an unborn baby. I would make it sociably acceptable to take one's own life and invent machines to make it convenient. I would cheapen human life as much as possible so that the life of animals are more valued than human beings. I would take God out of the schools where even the mention of his name was grounds for a lawsuit. I would come up with drugs that sedate the mind and target the young, and I would get sports heroes to advertise them. I would get control of the media so that every night I would pollute the mind of every family member for any agenda. I would attack the family, the backbone of any nation. I would make divorce acceptable and easy, even if fashionable. If the family crumbles, so does a nation. I would compel people to express their depraved fantasies on canvas and movie screens, and I'd call it art. I would convince the world that people are born homosexuals and that their lifestyles should be accepted and marveled. I would convince the people that right and wrong are determined by a few who call themselves authority and refer to their agenda as politically correct. I would persuade people that the church is irrelevant and out of date and that the Bible is for the naive. I would dull the minds of Christians and make them believe that prayer is not important and that faithfulness and obedience are optional. If I were the devil, I guess I would leave things pretty much the way they are. What a sad statement when it comes to this country, to believe that prayer is not important, that we cannot shift the tide of things. I hear the call so strongly because I, in 1982, had an abortion, and my child, who would never have a voice on this earth, is calling out to me to become a voice for the unborn. And you know, recently I went to a woman's retreat, and we released a cry. And when I heard that cry go forth, I heard the cry of the silent screams of the unborn. And you know, I believe Nashville 7707 was the beginning of a cry that has been released that will shift the tide of things. But it only comes when each person has a voice. And I want you to know your voice matters. I see like a balance, a scale that is being turned. And it, you know, it's tipping, but it's each person as they get involved, as they speak forth truth, as they believe and trust God, as they pray with their whole heart, that we can change the course of this nation. So I encourage you, we have 7 o'clock prayer every morning at ICLV on our campus and on 10-20-07 at the Thomas Mac to get involved. And if you have not registered for the call, get online and do it today. Be part of the solution. Just, I see that, like, you know, the Uncle Sam wants you. I just see that in my mind. Yes, you. And you might be looking like, me? You are important. You matter. Your voice counts. Become a voice to this city. And may they hear the cry from Las Vegas that God is in the life-changing business, and things will shift as we partner together to see His kingdom come, His will be done on this earth as it is in heaven. Amen.